What's up, everyone? It's Brandon Melvin bringing you the real estate tip of the week for all you realtors out there. All right, so if you're new to the business and you're trying to learn how to make a CMA for maybe a buyer client or a listing presentation that you've got coming up, maybe you want one coming up and you want to be ready, this is the video for you. All right, so for all of you realtors in Central Texas MLS, otherwise known as Four Rivers MLS, this is going to be a good example how to run a CMA for your customers, hopefully soon to be clients. All right, so once you get to your home screen, it should look something like this. You'll go to the search bar, click the quick, because we're doing a residential quick. And I don't have anyone specifically that I'm looking for at this moment, any address. So we'll just pick one in a neighborhood in the area that I tend to service. So what you're going to be doing is when you have a home of interest, you want to find that specific neighborhood that that home is located in. Now, if it's different and it's not in a neighborhood and it's a little bit wide variety, maybe it's got some acreage to it, or something of that nature, then that's going to be a little bit different of a CMA. So, message in the comments if you want something more like that, and then I'll get back to you personally. But this is just for a generic residential home in a community in the area. So, let's just go with the subdivision that I am familiar with, that it is in the area that I tend to service. So, we'll do Sungate. Now, you'll notice that I have active and then pending, or even coming soon. Nothing is for sale right now in that specific neighborhood. That kind of sums up the market that we're in. You can see that the inventory is very limited. So keep that in mind when you're pricing things, either for a buyer or a seller. You need to know that the demand is great and the supply is limited. So that's going to cause, obviously, price increases potentially. So what we need is are some homes that are sold in the last 6 months here. So we'll do that. We'll click sold. And then what I want to do is just go to the map here real quick. I'm going to choose any house up in here that makes sense here. So all right, here's a bunch that have sold in the neighborhood. Let's just choose this property. 1621 Sunledge Way. Cool. We'll pull up the tax. What's really cool about this MLS is if that home was actually sold through this MLS, you can pull up the previous, see last listings, maybe some photos. It's really good and easy to do if you haven't actually toured the home of interest, maybe for a listing presentation and you're trying to get the information beforehand. But it's also good to speak with the customers and ask them for some any photographs or any kind of upgrades that they've made to the property so that they can so that you can give them a better idea of what the pricing could be for it. Right, so here's all of the information, taxing information. What's really cool about the Matrix MLS here in Four Rivers, it will actually give you some estimated values with the artificial intelligence. You can see the estimated value, the high range, as well as the low range. So hopefully, when we're done with our comparables, you'll notice that it should be right around this area. I would probably go out and say that we would probably have the more accurate numbers as the real estate professional, but it's just good to see that the artificial intelligence would be supporting our data that we find. Okay, so all the tax information here, again, year built, as well as potential values for it. So keep that data in mind there. Let's go back over here. All right, so we've got this address. What I also want to do is we can pull up. I already know the subdivision information, but if you didn't and you can find it, you go to the property search. And what we'll do is this home is actually in Guadalupe County. So we'll check that out. This is a good website to favorite if you don't know it already, trueautomation.com. That will help you in your search for a lot of county appraisal districts. Okay, so 1621. Let's see, what was that address again there? Sunledge Way. So we'll just start typing it in and it should pop up. There we go. So we have all of the data that we need for the home. And then again, you can see appraised value, year built, square footage, all kinds of good information, the deeds and when they've been warranted. We're actually going to need a little bit of information on this page here shortly, but you can see the neighborhood, Sungate. And then so what we can do is, yes, we found the home. Now what we want to do is kind of limit these homes, because if we look at the results real quick, you're going to see that the pricings have a wide variety here. So that just tells me that you can see this home is a lot smaller than, say, this one and this one. So we want to get some more comparable data to the one that is of interest, right? So this specific home, you can see, let's go. Square footage, 2335, based off of the county appraisal district, right? And then your built was 2014. Okay, so let's go back over here and we'll adjust the criteria. What we want to do is for the square foot. Now, the closer you can keep it, the better. For this specific home, I might say like 300 or 400 square foot plus or minus might be a good deal. So let's just do 2,000 square foot to 2,600 square foot and see. You can see we've gone from, I believe, 11 to 6. So that should make us have more comparables. And then we can go to the map and kind of see where they're at as well. All right, good deal. Looks like they're all there in the back side of the subdivision. They probably were built similarly in time frame as well. Let's see. Okay. All right. So you can see the pricing of the homes that have been sold and then the price per square foot. They're, again, similar in range. They're not so far off anymore. And then you can see also, yeah, 2014, 15, 18, 16. So a lot more comparable. And what I would recommend is to review each one of these homes. And now the market is very changing in this moment in time. So I would say that homes that have sold 2-3 months ago, 6-8 months ago, they're very different. So the closer that you can get to the date that is right now will be better. So looking at this again, you would have maybe seen pictures of the home or toured the home, you know, potentially with your potential seller, and you can see. These are some images of the home that we're trying to compare it to. So if you kind of know, hey, look, yeah, this is similar to the home that I'm going to bring comps to, then hey, it's probably got some validity to it. You know, granite countertops, nice solid flooring throughout. You can see vaulted ceilings, all kinds of good stuff. So some upgrades there, it looks like. All right, so let's just say, yeah, this one looks pretty similar to it. We'll go to the next one. Again, price per square foot, you can see size, year, okay, just to bypass a little bit of time, that one looks very similar as well, so does this one, and this one as well, again, sold at the end of last year, so it might be a little bit low, but we'll put it in there just for this example, okay, and then also sold last year, you could see a little bit higher on the price. But you can notice here that the square footage is a little bit lower than the one in that we're looking to compare to. So typically the price per square foot is a little bit higher when you have a smaller sized home. And then the opposite is also true. The larger it gets, the smaller the price per square foot tends to be. So just keep that in mind as well. All right, so all of these seem to be very close that we're looking for at the home in question. Now, we're going to go all the way back to agent single line now so you can see these are all the homes. Now, once you have all of them in place, what do you do at this point? All right, so we've selected them. Let's go to CMA. All right, now I just will, for ease purposes, copy this address right here. And then we'll go back over here, put it in this box. And now if you had the customer or client, you had their information, you would create a new contact, put that in there. And then we'll go to the pages. You can put your cover page. Now through your MLS, you can update your photograph, your information, all of that good stuff. And then it'll be in there. Now subject and adjustments. We'll put that in there as well for the CMA, the comparables. These are going to be all kinds of data, built charts as well for the customer, again, client to look at and review. And the static. This is going to be information as to why the client should use you as the real estate professional and some information on what you can do to provide value to the situation at hand, trying to help them either buy or sell. And then the map is also very important, so you know where the homes are that had sold recently around the subject property. All right, now for the subject, if you were a buyer's agent and trying to run comps for a home that your clients were looking to buy, you could just put that MLS number in here. It's going to fill in all the data. But since let's say this is on the listing side, what we'll do is we'll take this property ID, copy that, and then we'll bring it back over here. And what we'll do is fill that in right here, paste that. And it should pull up There we go, Sunledge Way. And we'll get all the data that it does have on file. Now, pro tip for you, if you wanted to swing by the house, take a nice picture of it, put it in here. That way you don't have this no picture available coming up. It's actually a picture of the house, and you're doing a little bit above and beyond what normal real estate agents might do. And then you'll want to fill in all this information as well. Maybe do 2334, any approximate acreage, things of that nature. And so that way you can have all of that information into the CMA, okay? Go to the cover. Again, it's going to be all of this information here. We can upload the picture. For the comparables, we'll select those, add from listing. All right, so we have all those in there now. Go to the map. And then this is going to give us an example of where the house is located with the ones that have been sold. Now to the adjustments, I recommend, again, new to real estate, need to build a team. Some of your team needs to include appraisers, lenders, title companies, inspectors, all types of people that are going to help you in your business, even home warranty companies that you can refer all of your clients to. Okay, so speaking of the appraiser, you can go and ask them, hey, so what is a half bath or an extra bedroom or how much square footage or a pool? What are these things going to add value or subtract value to the home in question? And so they can kind of give you some assistance in that aspect, but you can make adjustments to the pricing here. I'll just keep that the same for now. And then as for the pricing, it kind of gives you an idea of where the high, average, medium, and low is from the comparables that you put in there. Now you can fill this suggested list price in like they have here. I suggest giving a range if you're going to do that. I typically leave this blank because I want to verbally speak to my clients about that specifically when I'm in front of them. And then any additional notes that you want to put as well. So when you're done, you would click finish. You can either email it from here or you can view it and then print it and then email it to them that way with other documents that you need them to review. Now I recommend if you're going to a listing presentation or even presenting this to your buyers, if you're going to do it in person, bringing multiple copies for each individual that's going to be looking at it. So that way no one's having to look over someone's shoulder and feeling uncomfortable and trying to, shuffle through papers, but each one feels comfortable looking at this. So here you go, the information, comparative market analysis, going through this, you can see the homes that we did pull up. So this home, it's saying that potentially the price per square foot can be 152 and change per square foot. Now, doing the math on this real quickly, you'll notice that we're going to fall right into the range of what the MLS had already generated. It should be right around 354,000. And so going back to this page, okay, the estimated value 355, high 363, and then the low 348. So right within that range. Now, being the real estate professional, knowing the market, I would say it might be safe to go out on a higher proposal of price per square foot. Again, everyone's going to be able to have this data, including the appraiser and also including the buyer's agent on the other side. So you want to make sure that you, if you're going to price it a little bit higher, make sure that you don't go crazy in that aspect as well. So all this data is out there for everyone that is privy to it in the real estate industry. So moving on just a little bit, you'll see the comparisons of each home. Going past that a little bit, it gives you a price range, 329 to 362. Again, falling right in that range, and the details of the average homes that we have collected. Days on market, some graphs, good information for your clients to review. Moving past this a little bit as well, you'll get into some of the helpful information that why your customer, soon to be client, should choose you as the real estate professional to help them. Pricing recommendation, price per square foot there. And then this is that data that I was speaking of, activity versus timing, why you should list, why they should list with you if they're going to, your guarantees you offer for them, the effects of overpricing. Again, all of this stuff is very helpful to provide a case on why someone should use you as their real estate agent. That's it in a nutshell. If y'all have any questions, comments, they'd be greatly appreciated. Put them in the comment section here, and then stay tuned for next week's real estate tip of the week. If y'all liked it, please feel free thumbs up the video and then subscribe for more information coming your way. All right, thanks a lot. Y'all take care.